Let's talk about your character.
Yeah. So, where to start with that? I'm to try and make it as short as possible. He is someone who is literally caught in the middle. So if you think there's all of this virus going on and all of this situation going on that is set in 2015 in America, where even as an Englishman, every week I see something on my Facebook or something online about an altercation between a police officer and a young youth and maybe people rioting against that. Here's a policeman who got into the business, got into the law for the reason of helping people and wanting to make people's lives better and more peaceful and easier, and suddenly there's a situation where there is a question, an error of doubt that has arisen within his public about him and his intentions, and now he has managed to still have that reputation within Atlanta where people trust him, and then all of a sudden the government are coming up to him and saying, can you issue this statement? Can we use the trust that you've built up for you to say this? And he's like, no, you can't actually until you give me, you tell me exactly what's going on.
Do you feel like being on the outside of the containment gives you a very different drama than the people inside?
I think for Lex it certainly does, because his drama is, I mean, imagine if, do you have kids? Do you have a partner?
No.
You don't? Okay.
I can imagine.
You can imagine. Okay, so if you have the person that you most care about that's on the inside of an area and their life is potentially a threat and you're on the outside. I do. I have kids and I have a wife, and I would swap in a heartbeat for them. I'd like to think I'd swap in a heartbeat for them. I may just go, guys, it's been great. You know, good luck with that. So I think there's that drama. And then also to be the person that's manning the gate and trying to keep the people that are trying to get inside calm and settled and reassured is incredibly difficult when you know exactly what they're going through.
What are his reactions like? What do we end up seeing in the pilot?
So you guys haven't seen it?
He has.
Oh, you have. So you know it's on tonight. Are you coming tonight?
I don't know.
Okay.
This is the first I learned of it.
6:15, I think, somewhere. So you got time. And it's somewhere. I don't know where.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah, please do. But please come. It'd be lovely to see you there. His reactions are what we see in the first probably couple of episodes are controlled, but you see this kind of burn in his eyes and in his heart, and that intensity of wanting to get in and help your loved ones, but also having to stay controlled, because if he is the man that the public are looking to, and if he's the man that the government's looking to, if he starts to lose it and crumble, what's going to happen to his area? What's going to happen to his society? And that, again, is he's one of those guys who puts people first, you know, which is probably a blessing but also a curse in this environment, because maybe, you know, your survival instincts need to kick in for yourself. So.
Did you study the procedures of quarantine and policing?
No, I studied. I studied some procedures of policing because. So I met a guy from the LAPD, and then I met a guy. I met a guy from the Atlanta PD who I requested because he was African American, and I really wanted to know what his dynamic was, what he was doing, and that was incredibly helpful to chat to him about that. But the quarantining, I didn't want to know that much about, because I just just really want to discover it with every episode. The thing about this that really, really struck me, and I'll just tell you this really quickly, I read an article 2 weeks before I got the script, which was about Ebola and how that challenges our humanity. So, real quick, if you had a mother and a screaming baby, and you were able to say to that mother, don't comfort that baby in any way, we wouldn't have, HIV wouldn't have been as rife, and Ebola wouldn't have been as rife. But as human beings, it's kind of impossible to stop someone doing that. Then on another level, what happens is these kind of disasters happen over there somewhere in the world, and we carry on. We read the sports pages and carry on. So now, all of a sudden, what this show does, I think, is take that situation and puts it right in the middle of people that we recognize and sound like us and see what, how they deal with it. And that was a big point.
So you think people just think it happens over there. It's never
yes.
here.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. And so what happens?
So the show will bring it, now it's here.
Yeah.